So guys, today's topic for reference is herb virus. So basically we are gonna study about its uses and kinds and what are its diseases formed in real life and what is the use and structure or ultrastructure of herpes viruses. So let's talk about the basic thing, what is herb viruses in this video, okay? So it is a kind of enveloped DNA virus, okay? So very important point to note, it's an enveloped DNA virus. Enveloped DNA virus, okay? This is the first point. Next point is it's an isohedral core surrounded by a lipoprotein envelope, okay? This is isohedral core, okay? Isohedral core surrounded by a lipoprotein envelope, as I told you. Okay, so next is, this is a linear double-stranded DNA. Okay, linear double-stranded next is, this is large in shape and size, around 120 to 200 nanometer in diameter, second in size only to pox viruses. Okay, basically it's quite large in structure, not the small ones, and it ranges around to 120 to 200 nanometer. Okay, it has a capsid which surrounds the DNA core, and over the capsid is tegument, which is a protein filled region. So capsid basically surrounds the nuclei material, or DNA surrounds DNA. Okay, next is nuclear membrane derived lipid bilayer containing viral glycoproteins. So lipid layer consists of viral glycoproteins, which is very important for you all to understand and know what is it. Okay, so this is some of the basic information that you need to know. So this was something about herpes viruses. So next up, we are coming to the classification of it. Okay, so coming to the classification of herpes viruses, and what is it basically, and what are its uses to mankind, what are its, not uses, but what is its structure and what can it cause, how dangerous it is. So coming to this classification of it, okay, so in this classification there are 8 human herpes viruses. Okay, so there are 8 human herpes viruses. Human herpes viruses species are known today till date. So there are a variety of them, and formed and present in different organisms and plants and animals, okay, according to their need and surroundings. Okay, so coming to the classification, let's talk about it. So there are 8 of them. So number one is herpes simplex viruses. Okay, herpes simplex viruses type 1. Okay, this is very important for you to know which type it is. Next is herpes simplex virus type 2. Okay, next up is varicella zoster virus. Okay, okay, next is cytomegalovirus. Okay, next is Epstein-Barr virus. Next up we have human herpes virus type 6. Next we have human herpes virus type 7. And the last one, which is human herpes virus type 8. So these are some of the important classification that you need to know. As I told you, herpes simplex virus type 1, next is herpes simplex virus type 2, varicella zoster virus, cytomegalovirus, Epstein-Barr virus, human herpes virus type 6, type 7, type 8. Okay, these are some of the classification based on herpes virus. Okay, so this is something basic that you need to understand about herpes virus. So basically, it also can be classified on the basis on biological characteristics. So let's talk about its classification based on biological characteristics. Okay, this is something that you need to know. So on the basis of biological characteristics, number one is alpha herpes virus viridinae. Okay, this is alpha herpes virus viridinae. Alpha herpes viridae, virus is just a term for viridae, so instead of writing both, we'll write only one. So which is alpha herpes viridae. Okay, next is, which is the herpes simplex virus group. Next is the beta herpes viridae. Okay, next is the gamma herpes viridae. Okay, so these are some of the classification based on the biological characteristics. Okay, these are alpha, beta, gamma herpes viridae based on herpes bacteria, based on under herpes viruses. Okay, not bacteria, pardon. So wrong sentences words used. Okay, so next we have let's talk about herpes viruses and its type, some of its types in a bit detailed manner. Okay, so let's coming to, which is the last topic for this video, let's talk about herpes simplex. As I told you previously, herpes simplex virus, let's talk about type 1. Okay, and as well as type 2. Okay, so as I told you, these are these consist of two types, type 1 and type 2, and are distinguished by how these two, type 1 and type 2, are distinguished, how, which I'll tell you. These are distinguished mainly on two criteria. Number one is antigenicity. Okay, number one is antigenicity. Next is location of lesions. Okay, so let's talk about HSV1, which is herpes simplex virus type 1, which is above the waist and primarily in adults, which has many of the features such as cold sores, characteristics, that is not very important, just you have to learn the location, which is above the waist for herpes simplex virus type 1. Okay, and for type 2, its location is placed below the waist. Okay, so these are some of the basic important classifications of herpes virus that you need to know. Okay, so as I told you, it has a number of classifications of herpes virus based on the biological types and normal, and before the classification which I told you, which has 8 types of herpes viruses, Next, I showed you the classification based on biological types and its location for the important herpes viruses, which is the herpes simplex virus type 1 and type 2, which is present above the waist and below the waist. So that's it from my video of herpes viruses. Thanks for following. Keep watching. Thank you.